नमस्ते, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। स्टैंडर्ड थर्ड, चैप्टर 7, सेइंग विदाउट स्पीकिंग। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? सी, मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल अराउंड अस कैन स्पीक एंड हियर, बट देर आर सम पीपल हु कैनॉट हियर or cannot speak. But how they can communicate with other people? Do you know that? Means if he or she wants to say something, then if he is not able to speak, then how he will tell the other person what he is going to say? Right? So we will learn about that only in our 7th chapter, that is saying without speaking. Means how we can tell our thoughts or feelings without speaking any word. Okay, for example, when a child is very small, around after 2 years he will be able to speak a little words, but till that time he is not able to speak a single word. Then how your mother or you, even you also understand that your what your brother or sister is saying, then how you came to understand that? By their expressions or hand movements, right? So the such people who cannot hear or speak, they use the different actions or lip movement. Okay, so the person who cannot hear, they can understand what the other person is saying by their lip movement. Okay, and the person who cannot speak, they express their feelings or their words through the actions. Right? You might be playing a game also, Dumb Should Act. Right? In that game, one person is giving a name of a film or any action that you, then you have to perform that action, but you don't have to speak a single word in that game. Only through your face expression and hand movements you have to tell the name of that film. Okay, and the other person who are sitting in front of you, they will guess which film is that. You all are playing that game. Okay, so how you will come to know that what he is saying? Through his face expression and the hand movements. Okay, so there are special school also for such people, so they can go in that school and learn more things, or they can get educated. Okay, in that school they teach them different topics through the different actions by hand. For example, if you like any food very much that is made by your mother or which is very tasty, then how will you say it? Okay, and if you are saying all the best to your friend or your brother or sister, then how you say it? Okay, so like this there are different hand movements by which you can tell your words. Okay, so and whenever all the person is not perfect in each and everything, means some are good in running, some are good in sports, some are in learning. Okay, somebody's speech is very good. Okay, so when you go to the school, you can learn this each and different things from each other. Okay, so in this chapter there is a story of a brother and sister. So the girl's name is Chakku and her brother is Nandu. Nandu is Chakku's elder brother, and Chakku is deaf by birth. Deaf means she cannot hear by birth. Okay, but she loves to play piano very much. So she is playing piano very much, but she can't sing. And you might be thinking she has a problem in hearing, then how she can't sing? See, if you want to sing any song, then you must know the tune so that you can sing that song in rhythm. But she is not able to hear, so how she can hear the tune? That's why she is not able to sing. Okay, and she is going, now she is going to school with her brother. But although her mother helps her at home to learn different things through the lip movement. She is going to school, but still teacher and some student also don't understand some of the words she is speaking. Okay, so one day while Nandu was wearing the his sunglasses with big glasses, and the glasses were of black color. So Chakku told him to take out that sunglasses. So by looking in his eyes and his face expressions, he can understand what his brother is going to say. Okay, and we can understand through the lip movement and the action also. But beside these two things, we can understand others' feeling through their face expression. For example, if you are playing in a home and if you have broken any vase or a glass, then what will be your mother's expression? Okay, from their your mother's expression only you will understand that now your mother is very angry and she is going to beat you, right? And whenever your friend or your brother or sister is upset, then how you will come to know? By looking his face. Or if somebody is very happy, then you can see in his eyes or face or itself that he is very happy today, right? So in this chapter also there are given four faces, but they have not made any eyes, nose, ears, lips. Okay, so you have to draw face according to the situation. So the first situation is, the first boy is Aftab, and he has broken his favorite toy. So what will be the expression of Aftab? If your favorite toy is also broken, then what will you feel? You will be very sad. Okay, so you have to draw a sad face of Aftab. So like that only. There is a girl, Julie, and her little sister has born just yesterday. So she is very excited. Excited means she is very happy. So you have to draw a happy face of Julie. So now the next is Rutva's mother. So Rutva has broken the bottle of pickle while taking it from the kitchen. So as I said, if you broken something, then what will be your expression of your mother? She will be very angry. So you have to draw the angry face of Rutva's mother. Okay, now the last girl is Rehana, and she is very afraid of dogs. So while she was playing, a dog came in front of her. So she has become very afraid. So you have to draw a frightened face on Rehana's face. Okay, so by these movements you can understand what a person is feeling. Okay, so along with these, you can also understand by the different mudras. See, there is one dance form called Bharatanatyam. If you have seen the Bharatanatyam, then the performer says the whole story through the face expression, hand movements, and through the eyes by moving eyes like this. Okay, and hand mudras, they tell each and everything by these things. So in this chapter also given some of the mudras like this, then like this, like this, sorry, okay, then like this. So all these are the different mudras. So there are many more mudras also from which they tell their story. So without speaking a single word, they tells each and everything through their face expression, through their eyes and mudras. Okay, so in this chapter we have learned how we can express ourselves or our what we want to say through, first one is lip movement, the second one is through actions, the third one is through our face expressions, the fourth one is through our eyes, and the last one is through mudras. Okay, so everybody understood how we can know what the other person is feeling or wants to say by just looking face or different actions. So everybody cleared this chapter?
Thank you for joining us.